am so blessed. Amen. I will ask the media team, please. There is a video about the word that he had for our church. We are called Unshakable Church Bali. And we were asking God, what word do you have for us for 2018? And he gave us limitless abundance, unlimited abundance, limitless abundance. And when I came home, the very first month of the year, our bishop was talking about limitless abundance. And he was preaching from John chapter 10, verse 10, that says, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but I have come that ye may have life and have it more abundantly. So this brought such a big assurance in my heart that I am not so far away from the vision of the house. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Amen. And I've shown you that so that you can see those who will partner with us, so that you can see the work that is going on there. And we will be sending newsletters every month to tell you how Nancy and I are going. Amen. And how the church is going as well. Amen. I want to appreciate everybody who serves in this church. I want to appreciate, start preparing your hands. Amen. I want to appreciate everybody who serves at any capacity in this church. The children's ministry, the missions, the hospitality, the ushers, the men's group, the ladies' group, the youth, the media team, the intercessors, the ministry teams. Are you warming up your hands? The ministry team, our pastors, and our bishop and Pastor Alice. Let's give a mighty hand clap to the Lord for this. John chapter 12, verse 26, that those who serve me, Jesus was speaking, my Father shall surely honor them, both in this life and in the one to come. So those guys who serve in this church, Jesus has promised you that his Father in heaven, your Father, my Father, shall surely honor you. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
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 Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we acknowledge that there is no other God that is above you. You are high, you are lifted up. You are enthroned on high in this house today. We acknowledge that you are the Lord of this house. We acknowledge that you are the King of this house. And Father, we thank you for giving us an opportunity to sit together and hear from you and learn from you. So God, we submit everything to you, O God. We submit our bodies, our minds, our spirits, our ears, our eyes, everything that we are to you right now. And we ask that you may minister unto us in a special way. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Be thou glorified, be thou magnified in our midst today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. On the 15th of July, we are going to look at Luke chapter 15. Amen. No pun intended. Luke chapter 15 from verse 25. Amen, amen. We're going to read all the way to verse 32. And I'll be reading from the NIV version. Are you happy to be in the house of the Lord?
Yes.
Because I am so happy. I am so happy. Amen. Meanwhile, the older son was in the field. When he came near the house, he heard music and dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked him what was going on. Your brother has come, he replied. And your father has killed the fattened calf because he has him back safe and sound. The older brother became angry and refused to go in. So his father went out and pleaded with him. But he answered his father, look, all these years I have been slaving for you and never disobeyed your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat so I could celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours who has squandered your property with prostitutes comes home, you kill the fattened calf for him? My son, the father said, you are always with me. and everything I have is yours. But we had to celebrate and be glad because this brother of yours was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. I'll repeat verse 31. My son, the father said, you are always with me, and everything I have is yours. This is the Father telling us this morning. This is the Father telling you this morning. My son, my daughter, you are always with me, and everything I have is yours. Everything I have is yours. By the death of Jesus Christ on the cross, we became co-heirs with Christ of everything that the Father has. Of everything that the Father has. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He says, cattle on a thousand hills are his, right? Even those hills themselves, they are his. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Everything that the Father has, he has given it to you through the Son, Jesus Christ. By virtue of you being in Christ Jesus, you have access to every one of God's promises. For in Christ Jesus, all God's promises are yes and amen. Everything is available to you. Whether it is healing that you want, it is available to you. Whether it is joy that you are lacking, it is available unto you. Whether it is peace that you need, it is available unto you. Whether it is finances that you need, it is available unto you. Everything that is a thing, it is made by your Father in heaven. And he says, it is all available unto you. But now, we see this story of this son who everything was available. The fatted calf was available for him. The goat was available to him, but he did not access it. He did not access it. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Why is he complaining when this other son comes and a whole cow is slaughtered to him, yet he has never received even a goat? It is because he had not accessed his inheritance. He had not entered into the relationship with the Father as a son. He had subjected himself into slavery to the Father. And we find that in the Bible where it tells us, verse 29, this is what he says. But he answered his father, look, all these years I've been slaving. So he was not serving the Father. He was not living as a son in the house. He was slaving. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He was slaving. He was working hard. He was trying to please the Father. He was slaving. He had put himself. Yes, he was a son. But his attitude was that of a slave. And that's why he gets so angry when the brother comes and he's treated like a son. Because he's like, I've been here. Why haven't you been treating me like a son? It is because he had put himself as a slave. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And it is true with most of us Christians today. Because once we receive the gift of salvation, we look at the cross of Jesus Christ, and we look at ourselves and we think of how undeserving we are for the death of Jesus Christ. I'm here to announce to you that God saw something in you that was worth his blood on the cross. Jesus saw something in you that caused him to willingly go on that cross. He saw value in him. He saw you not for what you have done. He saw you not for your fallen nature. He saw you for what he had created you to become. He saw you for your true self. He saw you for his image in you. He said, let us make man in our own image and likeness. And when we fell from this image and likeness of God. And so when he came to die on the cross, he came so that we can be restored back into who we were called to be. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so most of us Christians look at the cross and then we look at ourselves and we say, nimefanya dhambi mingi sana, nimefanya makosa mingi sana, lakini asante Yesu. Now, we enter into this relationship with Jesus as slaves. We enter into this Christian walk, not as sons that have been redeemed, But we make the mistake of looking at ourselves. We look at ourselves and we think of how undeserving we are, and we submit ourselves as slaves to the Father. The Father does not want slaves, because slaves cannot extend the Father's kingdom, because slaves cannot have a relationship with the Father. Slaves only receive orders and do orders, but sons reason together with the Father. Blessed be the name of Jesus. God said, let us make man in our own image and likeness. God did not say, let us make man in the image of an angel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, let us make man in our own image and likeness. In the image of God, you have been created. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, most of us Christians, we submit ourselves as slaves to God. And that's why we are not accessing everything that the Father has for us. This is why we are not accessing the abundant life that has been availed by the death of Jesus Christ on the cross. Yes, we have been redeemed from slavery, but our minds have not been renewed into sonship so that our lives can be transformed. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Look at what Adam did when he sinned against God. He went and hid himself. And then the Father came and was looking for him. Adam, Eve, where are you? And then Adam said, we are hiding because we realized that we were naked. What Adam did is that he looked at himself when he sinned against God. He looked at himself and he saw, I am naked. And he hid himself. He became self-centered. Blessed be the name of Jesus. He became self-centered and he looked at himself and he hid away from God. Because as long as you're looking at yourself, you will not be able to behold the Father and become the image in which you have been created. Blessed be the name of Jesus. This is when Adam submitted himself into slavery. He was a slave to the enemy and he was a slave to his own eyes, because he looked at himself and deemed himself unworthy of the presence of God. That's why he was cast out of the Garden of Eden. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we look at ourselves, we miss what the Father has for us. Praise the name of Jesus. Paul says, with unveiled faces we behold. We behold him. You cannot become that who you are not looking at. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Whoever, whatever it is you watch, that is what you become. Whoever it is you look at, that is who you become. Right? When you read the word of the Lord, you will become like the word of a God, of the Lord. When you look at your Father in heaven, you will become like your Father in heaven. In our families, we are a product of what we saw our parents do. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In our schools, we are a product of what we saw our teachers do. Hallelujah. And so we cannot become children and sons of God unless we are looking at the Father. We cannot be fully redeemed into our original purpose and actually have access into everything the Father has unless we look at the Father. Therefore, fix your eyes on Jesus, who is the author and the perfecter of your faith. Hallelujah. As long as your eyes are fixed on Jesus, you will be able to walk on the water. But as soon as you look at yourself and look at the circumstance around you, you're going to start sinking. Praise the name of Jesus. We need to continually gaze at the Father. We need to continually look at the Father. Praise the name of Jesus. Christians today are known for what they don't do. Ule ni Mkristo kwa sababu akunywi wake. Ule ni Mkristo kwa sababu haendi kwa bar, hafanyi vitu hizi zingine. Christians should not be known because of what they don't do. Christians should rather be known of their passions. Christians should be known of what they actually do. Praise the name of the Lord. The first time they were called Christians, it's not because of what they were not doing. It is because of what they were doing. They were walking like Jesus Christ was walking. Their shadows were healing the sick. They were walking like Jesus was walking. They were doing good. Praise the name of Jesus. And then these people saw them and they were like, hey, these guys are like Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Remember that guy, Jesus Christ of Nazareth? These guys are like him. scare some Christians. Yeah, scare some Christians. But today, in our culture today, Christians are more known of what we do not do. And therefore, people do not want to be like us because they think we have become slaves to some form of righteousness, to some form of godliness. Praise the name of Jesus. They think, Mr. Kipoko, kami, wakati yangu bado hajafika. Sita, acha ni enjoy life. Praise the name of the Lord. Because when they look at you, you look like you're not enjoying your life. Hallelujah. You look like you're slaving. You look like, atunena kabisa. Nani sana, nakesho kwa kazi. And then you, the Christian, you're like, unajua lazima tuende. Because of what you want. Wacha tutuwe. No, that should not be an attitude of a Christian. A Christian goes to the house of the Lord because he's like, my friend, my father has something for me to do. Hey, if I was you, my neighbor, I would come with me. Praise the name of Jesus. We should be known for what we do rather than what we do not do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Your sonship is given, but your mindset needs work. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Israel was redeemed from slavery. When you look throughout the Bible, God has always been in the business of redeeming us from slavery into freedom. It is for freedom's sake that you have been set free. You've not been set free for slavery, no. You have been set free for freedom. You're not being converted from one master to another master, no. You're being converted from one master into freedom, master. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You're not being converted to one type of slavery to another type of slavery, but you're being converted from slavery into freedom. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
But now our problem is that we are like the Israelites. Though they were saved from slavery in the wilderness, they were still thinking like they were slaves. They still had the chains in their hearts, in their minds. The chains were still there. That's why every time there was a bit of a problem, they will start complaining. Moses, umetuleta huku, tukufe, tukuliwa na wanyama wa porini, ungetuacha huku, tukufe, ndio tuzikwe kwa makaburi ya kweli. They still had Egypt in their minds. They still had slavery mentality in their minds. And this is sad because most of us Christians are still like that. We always look back and remember, kama singekuwa nimeokoka. Ningeingia kwanza hii season ya World Cup. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ningeingia kwa klabu nichukue 2, 3, 4, 5, ni analyze hiyo mpira. Lakini vile tu nimeokoka. Nitawatch na bibi yangu kwa nyumba. Praise the name of Jesus. I heard them talking and they were saying, Cameroon's G. I don't watch soccer like this. So I'm sorry. France, yeah. France, maybe it's just an affair. You'll be like, Nike, kwanza ni wapi tunenda, ni wapi ni sports, if you kasarani, tuwende, tutakula mbuzi, na tutakunywa. But now, because I'm a Christian, chatu ni nunuwe mkata na maziwa ni peleke nyumbani. We still have a slavery mindset in our minds. Praise the name of the Lord. We still have chains. We still think that we are Christians because of what we do. We are not Christians because of what. We still think we are Christians because of what we do not do. We are Christians because of what we do. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
But like when a sports team, content now to talk about North finance. Thank you, Bishop. Now, Dada Pia, Bishop Sana. Amen. So, yes, Christians are Christians because of what we do, because of our passions. Amen. Wacha watu wakujue kwa sababu ya zile vitu zenye unafanya, si zile vitu zenye haufanyi. Amen.
Amen.
So, we need our minds to constantly be renewed. Amen. Present your bodies, therefore, to God as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable. This is your spiritual act of worship. Do not be conformed any longer to the patterns of the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Praise the name of Jesus. Most of us Christians want to know the will of God for our lives, but we do not want to follow the instructions so that we can get the will. We don't want to be transformed from slavery, from our mind. Because if you're a slave, if you're a slave, you will not know the will of the master. If you're a slave, you will not know the will of the master. You'll just be like, we must have to. You will not know the will of the master. You will not know. You will only live from a place of orders, from a place of dependency, from a place of just let us just do our best, because that is a slave mentality. A son knows the will of the father. The father is not looking for slaves. The father is looking for sons and daughters. People who he can reveal his plans to him. Just like he revealed to Abraham. He was like, Abraham, I am about to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. What do you think about these things? Praise the name of Jesus. And then he told Moses, I'm tired of these people. I want to destroy them. What do you think? We can start all over again with you and your family. We can just destroy them all. And Moses was like, you saved them from slavery. He talked. God is looking for a son he can talk to. God is looking for somebody he can relate to with. God is looking for somebody. God is looking for a relationship with you. The reason why he did not give, like Pastor Mwashingadi says, God did not tell Abraham, I want you to go to coordinate, to these coordinates, you know, longitude 57E and latitude ISO, right? He did not tell him that. He told him, let's go to a land that I will show you. Why? For example, if I send you to that plot over there and I tell you, and I will upload you. When you get at the entrance of that plot, it will demand you to speak to me again. You will be like, okay, you may figure what plot is that. And then I'll be like, that's a panda stairs. It will demand you to talk to me again because you'll be seeing many doors. But what? And this is what the father is looking for. The father is looking for people who will acknowledge him in all their ways. Abraham could not take a left turn or a right turn. He was always walking and being like, he was looking for somebody. God did not just call Abraham to go to a place. God called Abraham to come to him. Praise the name of the Lord. Christian, God has not called you to not do the things that you used to do, but God has called you to come to him that you may do his will on earth, that his kingdom might be established on earth through you as it is in heaven, because you are being redeemed. You are being transformed back into his image and likeness. You are supposed to be a representative of God here on earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have been created to be representatives of God. Amen. The Holy Spirit told me that today we are going to be crossing over. Turn to your neighbor, tell them, cross over.
Cross over.
Cross over. I'll invite the worship team. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to make some declarations today. And we're going to cross over from a slavery mindset into a sonship mindset. From a place of pity for yourself because of how bad you are, to a place of thank you, Jesus, because of how good you are to me. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I'll invite all of us to stand up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Reveal yourself to us, mighty God. We ask you, O God, to take away our slavery mindset, oh God. We ask you to open up the eyes of our understanding, mighty God, that we may know that we have been redeemed, that we may know that you have called us sons and not slaves, that we may not become like the older son, but we may become your children, mighty Father, that we may become your sons, loved and accepted in the beloved. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth? Matchless love and beauty, endless worth. Nothing in this world can satisfy. Jesus, you're the God.
long as Moses' hands were lifted up, the Israelite army was prevailing over the Amalekites. And today I want to lead us into a prophetic act, an act of faith. I want us to move from a place of slavery, and I want us to enter into a new dimension. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So look for space, look for space, look for space. Look for space where you can be able to step forward. It'll just be one step forward. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence here. Thank you, Father, for what you're doing in our hearts. Thank you for what you're doing in our souls. Have you gotten yourself good space? Good space, good space. Even in the balcony, look for space where you can just make one step forward. And we're going to do this together. Praise the name of Jesus. And we're going to go through these declarations before we step. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to repeat after me. Say, as I take this step, say it with conviction and boldness and faith. As I take this step, in the name of Jesus, I step into a new level of faith.
I step into a new level of glory.
I am no longer a slave.
I am a son of God.
I come out of a slave mindset
into a sonship mindset.
In the name of Jesus,
I step into a new dimension.
I step into the realm of possibilities,
where everything is possible
and nothing is impossible.
I step into the realm of abundant life.
Limitless abundance is my portion.
I step into the realm of miracles,
into the realm of science,
into the realm of wonders.
I step into the fullness of life.
I step into my inheritance as a son of God.
I step into my healing.
I step into my deliverance.
I step into my freedom.
I step into my restoration.
I step into my season of kingdom manifestation.
In the name of Jesus,
I want you to put your left leg in front. Blessed be the name of Jesus. We are crossing over. Hallelujah. We are crossing over from the desert into the promised land. We are crossing over from slavery into sonship. We are crossing over from lack into abundance. We are crossing over from sickness into health. We are crossing over. Blessed be the name of Jesus. In the count of three, we shall bring the other foot forward and we shall give a mighty shout to the Lord. Hallelujah. Are we ready?
Yeah.